And now it's time for On the Money with your host, Dan White. Dan has been in the financial services industry for over 25 years, and he's been a featured expert in Forbes, Yahoo, the Philadelphia Business Journal, Dow Jones Market Watch, and has appeared nationally on Fox Business News. Dan is a member of some of the most prestigious financial organizations, including the Society of Financial Service Professionals and the National Association of Insurance and Financial Advisors. In addition, he's a chartered life underwriter and a chartered financial consultant. Credentials you can trust. Broadcasting from the heart of Wilmington, Delaware, here's your host of On the Money, Dan White.
A lot of times in life, we just wish things were simpler. You know, why does life have to be so complicated? You know, it simple is usually better, and nothing makes more sense than simplifying our tax code. But unfortunately, our government does not view things that way. Our tax code is so complicated, so complex, and the government just keeps making it more and more confusing. Welcome to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White, and I am the host of your show. This morning, we're going to peel back the most recent tax legislation that the government put out there. And inside of this legislation that was passed in December is about 350 pages called the Secure Act 2.0. And we're going to peel this back, the layers of the new Secure Act 2.0, and tell you what it means, what are some of the major things inside the act, and what it means for you in particular. Before we get into the program, though, we do have a white paper, very timely, the Secure Act 2.0, what it means for your retirement savings. So we're going to talk about it a lot today, but this would be a great addition to your library. So if you'd like to get a copy of our white paper, the Secure Act 2.0, what it means for your retirement savings, pick up the phone and give us a call. We're happy to mail that out to you. You can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, that's 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's local call, 610-358-8942. 610-358-8942. This month, we're going to be rolling out our webinars. So if you'd like to watch one of these programs in the comfort of your home, pick up the phone, call the office, get on our email list so you know when and where these programs will be airing. We have our seminar calendar, which is rocking and rolling for January and February. Officially live on our website and Facebook pages. Be sure to visit us online for a full list. We have three this week. On Tuesday, February the 7th at 5:30, we'll be at Buckley's Tavern on Route 52 in Wilmington, Delaware. Also on the 7th at 5:30, we'll be out at Deerfield Country Club in Newark, Delaware. And then on Wednesday, February the 8th at 5:30, we'll be up at the General Warren Inn up in Malvern, PA. And all three programs will be our popular Today's Retirement Concerns and Solutions. So if you are near the age where you've got to make those tough decisions about Social Security and lump sum pensions and what to do with 401k plans, by all means, you want to come out to one of our upcoming events. So the government has stepped in to help your retirement make it safer and better, and as I said earlier, a little more complicated. So again, we're peeling back the layers of the new Secure Act 2.0. The larger bill was passed at the end of last year, and here's why it's important and why you should care. The goal of the 350-page act is to make sure you have more money in your pocket at retirement. Secure 2.0 made 100 or more changes across many parts of the U.S. retirement planning landscape. It uses various income tax and other incentives. Congress is trying to reduce the anxieties of millions of American workers who are afraid of not having enough money in their retirement accounts. Market volatility and high inflation make their anxiety a lot worse. And the government really likes Roth IRA accounts. Why? Because people pay taxes immediately, which helps Congress find the taxes to pay for the benefits the rest of their law provides. Congress knows that retirement planning is of critical importance to all Americans, especially to those that vote. That is why they pass retirement planning laws now and will surely pass more laws in the future. So let's look at the parts, those parts of the Secure Act 2.0 that we are most likely to use with you. The most valuable retirement changes perhaps are those made for Roth conversions. Secure 2.0 makes Roth options much more available than before 2023. Think of Roth accounts this way. After-tax money becomes never-taxed money. Roth accounts happen in one of two ways. First, you can begin with the contributions of after-tax dollars that grow income tax-free and are income tax-free when distributed. So not only the money you contributed, but the earnings. Second, Roth conversions, you can convert tax-qualified retirement funds like IRAs and pay income tax on the amount converted to a Roth account. That money then also grows tax-free and remains so when distributed. So in our practice, we often recommend the use of a partial Roth conversion strategy over several years or more. We fit a course of annual conversions to the client's situation and objectives. That strategy will probably be applied even more often in the future. It always was a great idea, and now Secure 2.0 encourages more income tax reduction long term. Many more types of retirement plans will now allow Roth account options to be added to plan choices. One example of this is the SEP, the Simplified Employee Pension. This is one of the major changes in 2.0. A SEP will now allow a Roth option where it could not before. SEPs are very popular with self-employed individuals and small businesses, and this change will provide more flexibility and benefits. National IRA expert Ed Slott says, do Roth conversions now and in the next few years, especially if you are blessed to have higher retirement account balances. He believes income taxes are going up. Well, I am name dropping today. I share with you that the Roth IRA was named after its sponsor, William Roth, who was a U.S. Senator for Delaware for 30 years until 2001. Some of you might remember him. He probably never imagined how important his favorite tax-favored retirement option has become in the 25 years it has been available. The Secure Act 2.0 makes another couple of changes to RMD beginning ages. You know, you might remember until 2020, the age for beginning required minimum distributions from IRAs and qualified retirement plans was 70 and a half. Well, praise God they got rid of that. The first Secure Act raised the age to 72 for 2020 and beyond. I mean, 70 and a half was a colossal nightmare. Nobody knows when their 70 and a half birthday is. It depended on whether you were born January 1st to June 30th, July 1st to December 31st. A lot of times people were using the wrong factors. It was a mess. But the Secure Act, the first Secure Act, which passed in 2019, raised the age from 70 and a half to 72 for 2020 beyond. Well, guess what? Secure Act 2.0 raises it again, the RMD beginning age, to 73 for 2023 and to age 75 for 2033. You got all that? So again, they don't simplify things. They tend to make things a little more complicated. First thing you need to know, though, if your RMD start year was 2022 or before, nothing changes. You will just continue what you were doing. These new starting age changes don't matter if you have already reached your RMD age. If your RMD start year would have been 2023, then you should take something out in 2023. Keep in mind, you can wait until April 1st of 2024, but then you would have to take two in the year of 2024. Another way to look at this is those born from 1951 to 1959 have their RMD start year as the year they turn 73. If you were born in 1960 or later, your RMD starting age will be your age 75. But I got to tell you, this doesn't mean a whole lot for a lot of people. A lot of people have to start digging into their retirement accounts long before the age of 73 or 75. They need money to live on. And actually, if you retire early, if you're in your 60s, this is where tax planning really comes into play. The idea, again, is to hold off on Social Security, at least for the higher of the two wage earners, as long as possible. Again, it's growing by 8% compounded. It's ridiculous, okay? It goes up 8% a year, and it's inflation-adjusted. So you really want to look at holding off on Social Security as long as possible. But if people retire early, they say, hey, you know, I got to pay the bills, I have to eat, draw down on the IRA accounts. You're liable to be in a lower bracket because you don't have any income at that point. So start drawing the IRA accounts down, use up some of the credits that the government gives you, and try to defer Social Security as long as possible. So again, this doesn't really apply to a lot of people. The real wealthy, yeah, it's going to help them because it gives them a longer time period to be doing partial Roth conversions and other type of planning strategies. The second thing you need to be aware of is, so again, the RMDs are changing, and they are more advocating for Roth conversions. The government, you know, in their short-sightedness, they want tax revenue now. They don't want you to take deductions now. They want you to pay the tax now. You know, they're kicking the can down the road once again. Let me give you our phone numbers toll-free. You can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. This morning, we're talking and discussing some of the recent changes in the Secure Act 2.0. We're going to have more of these changes for you after the break.
Wall Street volatility up and down and up and down like any amusement park ride. Going up and down like this can make anyone queasy, especially when your hard-earned retirement dollars are at stake. Thankfully, there are strategies that can provide you with a reliable, predictable income stream. Dan White & Associates is ready to educate you on the options that are available, some of which provide a 10% bonus and 7 to 8% for income purposes. That's why you should call Dan White & Associates, 888-690-8820. Surrender charges and other restrictions may apply.
Welcome back to the On the Money Show. My name is Dan White. I am the host of your show. This morning we're digging into the Secure Act 2.0. There was over 100 provisions in the act that affected retirement accounts. We don't have the time to cover all 100 provisions, but we are digging into the most relevant ones as they apply to the people that we work with. And we're going to continue along this track. Before we continue, though, we do have a giveaway today, and this is called a white paper. It's called the Secure Act 2.0, What It Means for Your Retirement Savings. So if you'd like to get your hands on this, it'd be a great addition to your library of tax planning strategies. Pick up the phone and give us a call. We're happy to drop that in the mail to you. You can reach us at 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. In Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. We have several live events this week on Tuesday, February the 7th. At 5:30 p.m., we're at two locations. We're going to be at Buckley's Tavern on Route 52 up in Greenville, Delaware at 5:30 p.m. We'll also be down in Newark at the Deerfield Country Club in Newark, Delaware at 5:30 p.m. on Tuesday the 7th. And then on Wednesday, February the 8th, we'll be out in Malvern, Pennsylvania at the General Warren Inn at 5:30 p.m. All three of these programs are very popular. Today's Retirement Concerns and Solutions. So if you have questions about your retirement and you're wondering how we're helping people solve the same questions that you have, by all means, come out to one of our upcoming events. So before the break, we talked about, you know, raising the RMD age. It's going from 72 to 73, and then ultimately in 2033, it's going up to 75. And my rating on this provision, which goes into effect this year, is kind of neutral. You know, most people will not be impacted by it because most people are already taking out more than their RMD at age 72. Nearly 80% of people took out more than their RMD at 70 and a half, and it's likely that fewer than 20% that take the RMD only at 72. This number would drop even more by 73 and even further by age 75. So this provision mostly impacts people with wealth. You know, you might be asking, why did I include this? You know, because of Roth conversion planning opportunities. Pushing back the RMD age gives people more flexibility over when to spend their money, more planning opportunities for Roth conversions, and an increased ability to design smart spending strategies from their taxable retirement accounts. The best time to do Roth conversions is often after you've retired, when taxable income drops and before your RMDs are due. While you can certainly do a Roth conversion after RMDs have started, you need to do the conversion above and beyond what you owe that year from RMDs, often increasing your taxes. Instead, look for low tax rate years where you can do some conversion from a traditional IRA or retirement account to a Roth and keep taxes low. This extension also has the potential to exacerbate tax issues. Anytime an IRA owner waits to make distributions, that effectively means they will be squeezing future income into fewer years, and that can raise their tax bill. Another very interesting caveat of the Secure Act 2.0, they added a new way to do a tax and penalty-free rollover from a 529 account to a Roth IRA under certain conditions. Currently, money in a 529 that's distributed for non-education expenses can be subject to penalties and taxes. But under the new provision, beneficiaries would be able to do a rollover of up to $35,000 aggregate, lifetime aggregate, from a 529 to a Roth IRA in their name. The rollovers would be subject to the Roth IRA annual contribution limits, and the 529 would need to have been open for at least 15 years. Earnings and contributions would be treated like any other Roth account or rollover. However, the income limitation to be able to contribute to a Roth IRA is removed for the 529 to Roth IRA rollover, but the annual contribution limit remains. Now, my rating of this provision, which would go into effect in 2024, this is positive. The main benefit here might be to remove the uncertainty that happens if you were to overfund a 529 or if your kids don't need it. What if your kids don't go to college? What if they didn't need all the money? What if they got a scholarship? Now you likely can reposition that money back to yourself as a beneficiary to your Roth IRA or to your children's Roth IRA. For the vast majority of Americans, overfunding college expenses by $35,000 in 529 is not a big risk, but it can happen. But this does give parents a lot of certainty that if they do overfund, if their kid gets a scholarship, if they don't go to school, that the money can eventually be repositioned for this kid's retirement in a tax-advantaged way inside of a Roth IRA. So I think that is a very big positive. Section 325 of the Secure Act 2.0, they removed pre-death RMDs for Roth accounts. There will be no RMDs, no more RMDs for Roth accounts, such as Roth 401k or Roth 403b accounts pre-death after 2023. Currently, Roth IRAs are not subject to RMDs, but Roth accounts like 401ks and 403bs are subject to RMDs. This causes people to do rollovers from their Roth 401ks and 403bs to a Roth IRA to avoid the RMD. Ultimately, it was creating extra work and movement of accounts without really creating a universal policy or benefit. Roth IRAs and Roth accounts remain subject to the same rules pre-Secure 2.0 once the owner has passed away. So if you die with a Roth account, then you're subject to RMDs and the 10-year rule. But this is pre-death. So my rating on this provision, which goes into effect in 2024, is again very positive. This provision simplifies this question and reduces the need for rollovers to Roth IRAs. Since Roth accounts were subject to RMDs post required beginning date, you were generally advised to roll over to a Roth IRA that would not be subject to the rules. But that would sometimes force people out of a retirement plan or account that was otherwise better for them. While this was rare, it was an added complexity. And this new provision will simplify the process, allowing assets to stay in Roth 401k or 403b accounts and not be subject to lifetime RMDs. We talked a little bit earlier about SEP Roth IRAs and also simple IRAs. Currently, simple and SEPs do not allow for Roth contribution. Again, the Secure Act 2.0 changes this, allowing for simple plans to accept Roth employee contributions. And again, the bill would allow SEP IRAs to allow employees the ability to treat SEP contributions as Roth. The simple and SEP plans would have to decide to offer this feature as it is not automatic. My rating of this provision, again, is positive. This allows employees to get Roth tax treatment inside of SEP and simple IRAs. This makes sense because they are often starter plans for small companies and for employees not making a lot of income yet. And as such, their tax liability might be low at the time, and people would benefit more from a Roth than a tax-deferred account. Another thing in Section 603 of the Secure Act, catch-up contributions are Roth contributions. Currently, catch-up contributions can be a Roth or pre-tax, depending on what the plan allows. This new provision would require that all catch-up contributions would be subject to Roth tax treatment. There is an exception for employees with $145,000 or less in their Roth the previous year index for inflation who would still be able to opt into a pre-tax account. My rating of this provision, which again doesn't go into effect until 2024, this is negative. This is a tax revenue raising provision, increasing the catch-up contribution amounts earlier and requiring high-income catch-up contributing participants to do Roth will push revenue forward into a higher tax year. This is viewed as a tax revenue generator to offset some of the other tax cuts or tax benefit extensions in the bill. And lastly, this creates a great deal of complexity for plan providers, as many companies are not set up for Roth accounts and there was no grandfathering out of older plans. This will likely be some needed changes or regulations in the next year to help out existing plans. But overall, when you look at this overall, there was a clear lean toward Roth accounts, which pushes tax revenue forward for the government. It was used in certain areas of the Secure 2.0 Act to make the whole bill more revenue neutral. For instance, the mandatory Roth treatment of catch-up contributions is a revenue producer. Let me give you our phone numbers. Toll-free, 888-690-8820. Again, 888-690-8820. Pennsylvania, it's a local call, 610-358-8942, 610-358-8942. The Secure Act 2.0 created a lot of confusion, a lot of new rules. If you've got questions, we've got answers. Pick up the phone and give us a call. Have a great week.
The views and opinions expressed on this program are those of their respective parties and not those of this show's producers or this station. Join us again for more On the Money